So in this video, I will show you how to receive goods with and without a purchase order. And then I will show you how to move the goods and also show you a little bit on the warehouse map and the goods transactions finally. In my case, I have a red cube and a red cylinder in my articles list. You can see here how many of those I have, currently zero. To receive goods, I will start by going to warehouse and then receive goods. We're going to do it first without a purchase order. So that means this checkbox is not clicked. And here's a drop-down list of the articles, and I'm going to receive one red cube, and I'm going to put it in location A1, my floor location. And you see we have some optional fields here, which we're not going to touch in this video. So click save, and then I get this message, insert successful. And then I'm going to take a red cylinder, and I'm going to put that also on my location A1. Click save, and the insert was successful. Now we can go to the warehouse map and see that we have two objects inserted in location A1. And then we're going to also receive with the purchase order, and then we're going to move the goods to our wall location here. So let's go to order and purchase order list. And here you see that we have a purchase order. Now you can of course receive goods through a purchase order using the scanning module. This would be this right here, but we're not going to do that now. I'm just going to use the admin interface. So I select the purchase order, which in my case has one red cube and one red cylinder advised. So we select that, and then we click directly on receive. And this actually takes us to the page where we were before, but with the checkbox purchase order checked, and then this purchase order that we had. So we got, here it says 0 out of 1, but we got one of them, and we're going to put it on A2 and then click save. And then we go to the next in the list of that purchase order and say that we found one, and we're going to put it on stock location A2. So if we now go to the warehouse map, you see that we have also gotten two objects here on A2. And now if you want to go back to the articles list, you see that you have a count here of two of each, and you can also check your goods info, and here you will see on what location you have these new objects that we have received. So what we are gonna do now is to move the objects. So we go to stock movement, and we're going to take from position A1, we're going to take, let's first check where we're going to put them. Let's put my cubes here and my cylinders here. So this is the place for the cubes, and then this is the place for the cylinder. So let's go to stock movement again. Let's start moving from position A1 and take my cube and put it to wall 0104 and click move. And then once again from A1 to wall 0204, that would be my cylinder. Click move, and then from location A2, we're going to take one cylinder and move it to my wall location, sorry, one cube, and first move it to this wall location, and then take the cylinder and move it to the other location that I specified here. Click move, and you get this message that the update was successful. And now you can go to the warehouse map, and you see that here we have two red cubes. We also have information on them. here. You can, of course, change the appearance of this grid, but this is to insert more columns and so on. But this is topic for another video. Yeah, and then finally, let's check the goods flow and goods transactions, and let's search for transaction date. Let's do today's date here. And then we see that first we received two of each of those, and then we moved them to the locations here. So that means you get a good traceability in the system. So it could be very useful should you lose goods and so on. But that is it for this video. Thank you very much.